Hey, it's Aaron, the host for Mobilereviews-eh.ca, and what do you guys value, protection or functionality? You're gonna have to think about those two things if you're thinking about getting the Naztech Vault Plus for the iPhone 5 and 5S. During our review period, we discovered that getting to your iPhone inside the case kind of stinks, but it does provide exceptional protection for your iPhone in terms of water protection. Coolest features about this case is that it's waterproof up to 16.4 feet or 5 meters, which is pretty crazy. That's 2.5 times your standard LifeProof and Otterbox cases. Based on our time with the case, we do really think it suit an outdoorsy person quite well, maybe not an office person, and because of that, we gave it a score, 3.9 A's out of 5.
Real usage, real reviews. Mobilereviews-eh.ca.
Now, our reviews at Mobile Reviews are actually based on real usage, so we don't try to find pictures on the internet and say, this might look like a good case. We've actually used this case out in the wild, like, see, kayaking. We try to film as much stuff as we can with the case. We filmed the entire unboxing, and we were pleasantly surprised at the sticker that we found inside the case that told you to do the water test. So we actually went and did the water test. We put it in the kitchen sink, and then we tried to drown our iPhone inside of it. And we've also done a drop test, even though the Naztech Vault isn't really rated to a specific mil spec. Now, this case was brought to our attention several months ago. Creepy couple passes didn't mention it in one of their comments to us. Now, we did reach out to Naztech, and that was about 2.5 months ago, and they said, yeah, totally Mobile Reviews. We'll send you a Vault and a Vault Plus for you guys to review as well as give away to your viewers. It's been 2.5 months. I'm still waiting for those cases. I got impatient, so I ended up buying this case myself. It's not a cheap case, and the shipping was kind of brutal, so yeah, I'm out like 90 bucks. Getting to your iPhone is pretty not great in this case. The True Tone flash is actually covered by this like pinhole thing. The screen protector is pretty gappy. There's quite a bit of gap between the touchscreen and the screen protector, and the sound coming from your iPhone is quite muted. I'm gonna take the next few minutes and go over the more unique features of this case. If you need a complete breakdown of everything about this case and how we score it, do check out the review table on our website. It's got everything there. Links are in the description section below or the annotations at the end. Now, we'll be honest with you, the Naztech Vault Plus is a different looking case. On our Facebook page, Jesse Murillo and Ensign Chu seem to have mixed reactions about the look of the case, and we totally agree. The case has a lot of texture, which makes it really easy to hold on to in pretty wet situations. Now, the back of the case is pretty slick. It's got no rubber on it. It's pretty frictionless. There are a couple of odd things with installing this case, but I'm not going to elaborate on them because I'm trying to keep this video kind of short. Check out the review table if you need to know more. For protection, the Naztech Vault Plus is actually one of the very few cases that I would feel incredibly comfortable taking into the ocean. The only reason for that is because of how this case is designed. The front housing actually wraps around the back of the case, and so as the water pressure increases, the water pressure is going to basically force the housing to wrap around the back even tighter, creating a better waterproof seal, which is probably why it is waterproof up to 16.4 feet or 5 meters. In terms of drop protection, well, we did drop it from 6.6 feet, even though we realized after that Naztech doesn't really say that you can drop it from that height. But this case will provide you with two layers of protection, the outer rubber housing, and then inside you've got, or the back of the case, you've got that sled. In terms of screen protection, it's got a nice thick screen protector that scratches pretty easily, and there's a brittle gap between the touchscreen and the screen protector, which provides a bit of cushioning. Now, speaking of that gap, that is one of the reasons why the functionality of the iPhone really suffers. It's about a millimeter. It doesn't seem like much, but because of the rigidity of the screen protector, you kind of have to push really hard. What makes it even worse is that the gap isn't consistent throughout the entire case, so you don't really have to push that hard to get to the edges of your iPhone, but in the middle, you kind of have to just stab your finger into it. The sound coming from the bottom of the iPhone is muted quite a bit because there's actually no cutout for the sound to escape. Now, we were thinking that sound was going to be pretty awful for the earpiece speaker because it looks like it's fully covered, but that white membrane actually lets sound out quite well. It's kind of the same setup for the microphone, and it's a little different because it's like it's got this like empty space for the microphone. It looks weird, but it does work. Now, if you're using non-standard Apple accessories, you would have an issue with the headphone jack and the lightning port connector, but again, those details are in the review table. I do have to mention that the Touch ID is incredibly awesome with this case. The membrane, I think, is generally bigger than your standard LifeProof and Otterbox cases, which is why it works. Like, it just feels like there's nothing there on top of it. It's kind of weird, but the Touch ID sensor works really well with the Naztech Vault Plus. Now, the True Tone flash on the back of your iPhone actually becomes a True Tone spotlight. This weird pinhole thing is transparent and light does travel through it, but it really reduces the extent of how far your True Tone flash can shine. So your flash photography is gonna end up pretty weird. Now, also the screen viewability suffers quite a bit. The screen protector scratches quite easily, which is very surprising to us given how thick it is. It scratches so bad, you don't really notice it when the iPhone is off, but we've been using it for so long that you can kind of start seeing those scratches when the iPhone is actually on. So yeah, not too great. So again, this is a good case for the avid outdoorsman, I do believe, who doesn't use their phone much, but it's a pain to get to your iPhone inside the Naztech Vault Plus. Again, we gave it a score of 3.9 A's out of 5. If this is the first time you're watching one of our videos, I do encourage you to click subscribe, as our channel is all about helping you get the most out of your iOS devices. So products, reviews, news, tips, and tricks. As I mentioned earlier, this case did not come free. We did not get it from the manufacturer. It came out of our own pockets. So if you feel like supporting us and you do like what we do at Mobile Reviews A, do consider supporting us through our Patreon campaign. Links are in the description section below. I'm Aaron the Ho. These little jars are filled with expensive teas. And I'm done talking. Thanks for watching.